For anyone looking for a career in flight, choosing the right path for your flight training is a critical step in your aviation journey. Two regulatory frameworks guide pilot training in the United States, FAA Part 141 and FAA Part 61. Though both lead to the same certifications, they differ significantly in structure, oversight, and suitability for various student goals. In this video, we'll explain what FAA Part 141 and Part 61 training actually mean, break down how the two paths differ, and show why those differences matter for students choosing a flight school. Before we begin, make sure you like this video and subscribe so you don't miss more aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy. Let's get started.
My name is Ray Altmann and I'm the Chief Flight Instructor at Epic Flight Academy. Part 141 flight training is a type of flight training where the FAA approves a flight school to reduce the hours required to earn a certificate. Some other key details on a Part 141 course is there are what are called stage checks. Example at Epic Flight Academy, our courses are usually broken into 3 to 4 stages. Each stage will have an evaluation or a progress check done by a Part 141 check airman. And as long as you do well, you will move into the next stage. If you do not pass that stage check, you need to retrain and then reattempt until you are proficient. This goes all the way to the end of course. The end of course is the final stage check. And currently in our private and instrument courses at New Smyrna, the end of course is your check ride. It is what will issue your certificate.
Because of this oversight, Part 141 schools often resemble aviation colleges or academies, offering a professional setting that blends classroom study with hands-on flight training. Epic Flight Academy is proud to be the largest Part 141 flight school in the United States, training thousands of pilots from around the world every year. Students training under Part 141 enjoy several advantages that make the program structured and efficient. Reduced flight hours. Under Part 141, a private pilot certificate requires 35 hours minimum, and a commercial certificate requires 190 hours. This can save both time and money. Structured path. Students move step by step, building skills in a logical sequence. Integrated learning. Ground school is tied directly to flight lessons, reinforcing knowledge in real time. Stage checks. FAA-approved evaluations at key points keep training on track and ensure readiness before advancing. FAA Part 61 pilot training is another pathway recognized by the FAA that governs how flight instruction is conducted.
Part 61 is kind of the FAA traditional flight training. So if you look at the federal aviation regulations, it says that a private pilot needs these requirements, an instrument pilot needs these requirements. It's what the government or the federal aviation regulation has said that we need to have, you know, this amount of training before you can become this pilot.
Unlike Part 141, this type of training does not require schools to follow a rigid FAA-approved syllabus. Instead, any FAA-certified flight instructor can provide training under Part 61, whether they are affiliated with a flight school or working independently. This creates a more flexible approach to training, allowing lessons to be scheduled and customized around each student's pace and goals, while still requiring them to meet all FAA standards for testing and certification. Students training under Part 61 also enjoy several advantages that make the program flexible and accessible. Flight hours. Under Part 61, a private pilot certificate requires 40 hours minimum, and a commercial certificate requires 250 hours. While this typically takes longer, many students appreciate the flexibility it provides. Flexible scheduling. Students can train full-time or part-time, making it easier to balance flying with jobs, school, or family commitments. Customized learning. Instructors can adjust the pace and teaching methods to fit each student's needs and goals. More instructor options. Students are free to work with any FAA-certified flight instructor, whether part of a school or independent. Ideal for recreational flyers. Many students who fly for leisure, rather than pursuing a professional career, find Part 61 more convenient and accessible. When deciding between Part 141 and Part 61, it really comes down to your goals as a pilot. Part 141 training is often the better choice for students planning a professional career in aviation. If your goal is to fly for the airlines, work in corporate aviation, or follow a structured path that moves you forward as efficiently as possible, Part 141 offers the accelerated, college-style training environments to get you there. On the other hand, Part 61 is ideal for hobbyists, career changers, or anyone who needs the flexibility to train around a busy schedule. With its personalized go-at-your-own-pace approach, Part 61 makes flight training more accessible for those who want to learn how to fly on their own terms. For international students, Part 141 is usually the required path since it qualifies for student visas, while Part 61 programs do not meet visa requirements.
So in a 141 flight training atmosphere, the instructor is going to work specifically in that stage until the student passes that stage. In a 61 course, they have a little more freedom to work at on whatever they would like at that time. A good example of this is if you were a 141 student and you were waiting to solo, you might have to wait until you pass that solo stage check and then you can go do it. Maybe the weather's bad and you can't solo these next couple weeks, but there's time to do landings. Well, you really can't work past the solo stage. A 61 student, they could recognize, well, the weather's not going to be good to solo this week, but we can go do some other things. They can work on other units that are further ahead in the course and then come back to that solo activity and solo when it's better weather.
Whether you choose the structure of Part 141 or the flexibility of Part 61, both paths lead to the same FAA pilot certificates and ratings. Airlines, cargo operators, and charter companies don't distinguish between them. What matters is building your experience and meeting the qualifications. The real question is, which style of training fits your goals and lifestyle best? And at Epic Flight Academy, we're here to guide you every step of the way. Thanks for watching. If you're exploring the differences between Part 141 and Part 61 and deciding which path fits your goals, be sure to like this video and subscribe for even more aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy.